Hi, I'm Trev. I'm going to show you how to create a workflow template in Aconex and activate it so that it can be used to start a workflow for a set of documents. You can use a workflow template any number of times for sets of documents that go through an identical review and approval process. So click Workflows on the module menu and under Create New, choose Template. The first thing we have to do is give the template a name. It needs to be clear what sort of review process it's appropriate to use this workflow template for. The workflow note appears in the workflow transmittal and on the document review page and is where you enter any instructions for reviewers in workflows based on this template. Next, you need to choose how the final outcome of the workflow is decided. It can be either the outcome set by the final reviewer in the workflow or the lowest outcome set by any reviewer. So if the document is rejected at any step, it's rejected as the final workflow outcome. For now, we'll accept the default for this template. When someone uses this template to start a workflow, we can control what changes, if any, they can make to the workflow. We might let the initiator change how long a step can take, or whether they can choose to skip a step in the workflow. Again, for now, we'll just accept the default values. We can also set some default values for the workflow transmittals created during the workflow process. We can set the step completion rules for each step in the workflow individually, but to save time, we can set the defaults for the steps in our workflow and then just edit those steps that we need to. Again, we'll accept the default values. Our last option here is to add people that we want to be CC'd on the final transmittal in the workflow. Now we get to the fun part of actually creating our workflow process. We just need to drag and drop blank steps into our workflow. Workflow steps can be sequential, like we have here, or in parallel, like so. Let's add one more step at the end. Now we need to specify the details of each step. So we click this arrow icon and enter the step name, something meaningful, so other people know what this step is for. Then we'll add the person who will complete this step. We can add multiple participants, if required, or a distribution group. This will add the members of the distribution group at the time a workflow using this template is started. If necessary, we can CC other project members in this step, but we won't do that for this workflow. Click the OK button to save the step details. In the same way, we'll complete all the other step details for this workflow. Now, the other thing we can do is change the step completion rules for a step from the default values we set. Click this arrow icon between the steps, and we can choose a different completion rule for this step if the reviewer rejects the document. Click OK to save our changes. If we look at the completion rules for a parallel step, you can see we also have the option of changing how step completion is defined. We'll leave this as it is though. Now the last thing we need to do is set the duration for each step. This is the number of working days the participant has to complete a step before it's overdue. And the total duration of the workflow is shown here. We can save this template to draft if we want to come back later and rework the template. If we decide we don't need a step, we can delete it by clicking the X. Or if we're done, we can activate the template. Once the workflow is activated, the number of steps and the layout of the steps cannot be changed. So now your new workflow can be used to submit shop drawings for review. Okay, so now you know how to create a workflow template. You can create serial and parallel steps. You can save it to draft or activate it and make it available for use on your project. Bye for now.